In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who manifest your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. A reading from the book of Job. Job said, pity me, O you, my friends, for the hand of God has struck me. Why do you hound me as though you were divine, and insatiably prey upon me? Oh, would that my words were written down. Would that they were inscribed in a record, that with an iron chisel and with lead, they were cut in the rock forever. But as for me, I know that my vindicator lives, and that he will at last stand forth upon the dust, whom I myself shall see. My own eyes, not another's, shall behold him, and from my flesh I shall see God. My inmost being is consumed with longing. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
Hear, O Lord, the sound of my call. Have pity on me and answer me. Of you my heart speaks. You my glance seeks.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
Your presence, O Lord, I seek. Hide not your face from me. Do not in anger repel your servant. You are my helper. Cast me not off.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus appointed 72 other disciples whom he sent ahead of him in pairs to every town and place he intended to visit. He said to them, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest. Go on your way. Behold, I am sending you like lambs among wolves. Carry no mani bag, no sack, no sandals, and greet no one along the way. Into whatever house you enter, first say, 'Peace to this household.' If a peaceful person lives there, your peace will rest on him. But if not, it will return to you. Stay in the same house and eat and drink what is offered to you, for the laborer deserves his payment. Do not move about from one house to another. Whatever town you enter and they welcome you, eat what is set before you. Cure the sick in it and say to them, 'The kingdom of God is at hand for you.' Whatever town you enter and they do not receive you, go out into the streets and say, 'The dust of your town that clings to our feet, even that we shake off against you. Yet know this, the kingdom of God is at hand. I tell you, it will be more tolerable for Sodom on that day than for that town." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
If you've been following and listening to our first readings this week, we've been listening to the story of Job. Today's narrative of Job is but a reminder how hope and determination was true for Job. Malakas ang pananalig ni Job na kahit na ba inuulan na siya ng mga madaming masasamang bagay, magtatagumpay pa din ang Diyos sa kanyang buhay. He may have not seen beautiful things one after the other. If you will try to read the first reading last Monday. But he knows that his vindicator, God, will continue to live. Hindi tayo tinatapos ng problema, kundi kasama ang Diyos, tinatapos natin ito. Once I already said that to be a disciple of Jesus today, in a way, comes a lot easier. There are already various means of transportation. Some are blessed with privileges. Some are in a stable community or shelter, so to say. But then, to be a disciple of Jesus then entails a lot of surprising and even present challenges. You have to set on foot towards long distance journeys. You have to work doubly. You have to bear a lot of miseries. And I think Jesus reminded them of the different things that they will welcome and even encounter as they go on the mission. Pero kahit na ito ang mga babala ni Jesus sa kanyang mga alagad, sa paghayo niya sa mga ito, they still went to their mission. Humayo sila ng matiwasay. Alam nilang mahirap, pero nagpatuloy sila. Alam nilang pahihirapan sila. Alam nilang mabibigatan sila at sasakupin sila ng kasamaan. Pero humayo sila. And what seemed to be their energy in this life? I do believe, like Job, they know that God will live. Kasama nila ang Diyos. Kaya lalaban, hahayo, at magpapatuloy. We may encounter a lot of miseries. We will also be like the disciples, lambs sent in the midst of the many wolves today. Life may ask us of to let go of things, persons, and many. Generally, this life we live is a difficult one. But we hold on to this promise that God lives. Buhay ang Diyos na sasama sa ating lumaban at magpatuloy. Buhay ang Diyos na tutulong sa ating umahon. Kahit na alam nating mahirap, God lives in and will not stop from raising us up. Job suffered greatly. The disciples went ahead with a very difficult mission. We may have both experiences, o baka mas malala pa. But why continue? Why go along? Because God lives. God will take care. And God will be along the way.
Please stand.
We now turn in prayer to the Lord of the harvest, and we pray for the needs of the church and of the world. For every petition we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the faithful may be aware that they are called by God to spread His kingdom of peace in the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may be more conscious of our vocation to spread the good news of salvation to the people in our neighborhood. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That farmers who till the soil and work the land may be blessed with good weather and abundant harvest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and those who find life difficult may know that God cares for them through the concern of their families. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed, who labored in this life, may obtain their heavenly reward. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray in silence for our own intentions and lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass and our prayers for each other. We also lift up to the Lord all the delegates for the second session of the Synod on Synodality in Rome. May they be filled with the Holy Spirit and listen to the voice of God leading us to holiness and fullness of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, help us to take part with joy in the work of spreading your gospel by the example we show in our lives. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessing may be laid open before us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, joined with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Coming together as God's family with confidence, let us call on him as we pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Here I am, Lord.
Please stand.
Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united, whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.